Eid celebrated peacefully in all parts of Jammu and Kashmir. In Srinagar, people gather in large numbers at local mosques to offer prayers and greet each other. Jami Masjid in Old Town Baramulla witnesses more than 10,000 people offering prayers. Government takes series of steps to facilitate general public and employees in Jammu and Kashmir. Arrangements made for adequate availability of essential items. Banks to open even on holidays. 300 special telephone booths set up to help public communicate with their kin and relatives. J&K Governor Satyapal Malik says situation is absolutely normal in the state. Appeals to people of J&K to take part in development process. Greets people on Eid. India and China reassert resolve to carry forward bilateral relations to greater heights. External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar and his Chinese counterpart Wang Yi address joint press conference in Beijing. Relief and rescue operations intensify in affected areas of Maharashtra, Kerala and Karnataka and in Gujarat as well. Water recedes in Maharashtra's flooded Kolhapur district and Mumbai-Bangalore National Highway. Met Department predicts heavy rains in several districts of Maharashtra. Eid-ul-Adha being celebrated with religious fervor across the nation to commemorate the spirit of the festival. President, Vice President and Prime Minister greet people on the occasion. Hello and welcome to this edition of the news. I'm Rukma in our top story. Eid prayers were concluded peacefully in all parts of Jammu and Kashmir today. Prayers began at 7 a.m. at most mosques and continued till noon in some places. Movement of people was facilitated by police forces as necessary. People offered special namaz at mosques with religious fervor and enthusiasm. Eid prayers were offered peacefully in all local mosques of Anantnag, Baramulla, Budgam, Bandipore without any untoward incident. Jamia Masjid in Old Town Baramulla witnessed approximately 10,000 people offering prayers. Home Minister Amit Shah also greeted the nation on the occasion of Eid al-Adha. In a tweet, he said, "May everyone be blessed with joy, peace and happiness." And DG CRPF Rajiv Rai Bhatnagar celebrated Eid with CRPF and CAPF personnel and their families in Srinagar. Governor of Jammu and Kashmir Satyapal Malik appealed to people of the state to take part in the development process of Jammu and Kashmir. Speaking exclusively to DD News, JNK Governor said that there is normalcy in the state.
It's been 1 week since the monumental changes that have been brought about in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, and we are very privileged to have with us the Governor of Jammu and Kashmir, Sri Satyapal Malik. Sir, today is Eid ul-Zuha and the people are celebrating it, but there is Section 144 in place, but those were precautionary and also in the interest of the people. But at the same time, the government has taken several steps to ease the people's concerns and help them to celebrate Eid. How would you like to tell people, you know, what message would you like to give them on the day of Eid?
First, on the outset, I want to say that Eid Mubarak to them, and they should celebrate Eid with all dedication and piety. It is a very important festival for them, and I wish them well. We have eased all the restrictions yesterday and day before yesterday. Both the days were almost normal. Today also, in every mosque, almost every mosque in the mohallas, there was prayer. People prayed at the proper time, and after that they are mixing, meeting, everything is normal. At one or two points where there are some miscreants and they want to create some law and order situation, there we have to take some necessary action and restriction. There is no curfew in the town, and in no town in Jammu and Kashmir curfew was ever imposed. Only 144 was imposed. So things are normal, and I wish them well. Tomorrow also, this festival goes up to tomorrow and the half day after. So I again wish them that they should have a happy and peaceful Eid.
When, you know, there are so many restrictions like on telecommunications, perhaps many of them want to, you know, get in touch just to celebrate Eid in a more friendly manner. When would you like to tell them that, you know, those sort of restrictions will be removed?
We want to remove them at the earliest, but it's a weapon in the hands of miscreants. In past we have seen that all the radicalization comes through this, all the mobilization comes through this medium, all the wrong rumors come through this. Then even Pakistan uses this medium. So we cannot give weapon in the hands of our enemy or any enemy of the state. As soon as we see that things are getting normal, we'll remove these restrictions.
So what is your assessment of things as they are now? You said as soon as things get normal.
In such situation, you can't say anything. Everything is normal and something happens somewhere. And this weapon is in their hand. They'll spread it, spread rumors, and they'll create law and order. When in mujhe lagta hai, in coming 5-10 days, everything will be normal and we'll restore it back.
And a final word, what would you like to tell the people of Jammu and Kashmir today and for the next 3 days on their festival?
What I want to say is that they might have listened to the speech of the Prime Minister. He was very open, very honest, and you must say full of love for Kashmiri people. I want to tell them that now 370 is gone. It's not coming back. It was a false ego created in your mind as if you have got something very special. It went against your interest. Now your development will happen. People will come here, they will invest here, and we'll take care of it, about your children, that their admissions, will put conditions that their seats or their place will not be taken by anybody. I appeal to the people that it's a new India. Take part in the development of your state, and you have every potential to reach at the height. You'll be the most important state in the country.
So you talked about development and investments, mostly apart from horticulture and tourism, there doesn't seem to be much. People don't see more opportunities, but there are so many opportunities, and
so
the Prime Minister mentioned quite a few. And are the investments coming?
For IT department, there is no other state in the country where situation is so congenial for IT department. Then they have got lot of fruits horticulture mein, there is no value addition factories, they can be put, cold storage can be put, so many things can come here. And I'm not an entrepreneur so that I can tell you, but yes, lot of people are asking, can we put this factory, can we put that factory?
So there's a lot of interest already.
A lot of interest is, you know, and PMS said this morning,
right.
And there are a lot of queries.
And the future of Jammu and Kashmir is, what would you say? It's bright, very bright?
It's bright, and I call upon younger generation to take command of this state in their hand. Politics should be dominated by the younger generation, and they can reach at the zenith of this country.
Thank you very much, Mr. Satyapal Malik, for talking to us.
A National Security Advisor Ajit Doval today undertook an aerial survey of Srinagar and South Kashmir areas to take stock of the security situation as the valley celebrated Eid al-Adha. Officials said Police Chief Dilbagh Singh and Army commanders also undertook separate aerial visits of various parts of the Kashmir Valley. The officers found the situation to be absolutely fine, they said. Eid prayers were concluded peacefully across Jammu and Kashmir, they said. Union Information and Broadcasting Minister Prakash Javdekar said that people of Jammu and Kashmir have welcomed the scrapping of the special status and there is absolute peace in the state. Prakash Javdekar also asserted that people of the valley are celebrating Eid peacefully and with religious fervor.
ये जम्मू कश्मीर के आम नागरिक को न्याय देने के लिए, उनके अधिकार उनको देने के लिए यह ऐतिहासिक बिल पास हुआ और उसी दिन से ये सारे अधिकार वहाँ लागू हो गए. ये बहुत बड़ा परिवर्तन है और जम्मू कश्मीर के लोग इसका स्वागत कर रहे हैं. आज बकरीद है वहाँ, हम यहाँ भी सबको शुभकामना देते हैं और उत्साह से, और लोग बहुत अच्छे तादाद में उसको पूरा सेलिब्रेट कर रहे हैं.
BJP leader Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi offered namaz at Panja Sharif Kashmiri Gate in New Delhi on the occasion of Eid al-Adha and prayed for peace, prosperity, safety and harmony in the country. Let's listen in to what he said.
ये ईद जो है वो देश के लिए खुशहाली, देश के सम्मान और स्वाभिमान की और सुरक्षा की मजबूत संकल्प को मजबूत करने वाली ईद बने, और साथ ही साथ जम्मू कश्मीर, लेह, करगिल के लोगों को जो एक कहीं ना कहीं उनके विकास के रास्ते में एक रोड़ा था. जम्मू कश्मीर के लोगों के लिए आतंकवाद से आज़ादी की गारंटी है, अलगाववाद से आज़ादी की गारंटी है, भ्रष्टाचार से आज़ादी की गारंटी है, और साथ ही साथ विकास और विश्वास का जो माहौल वहाँ पर होना चाहिए था वो फिर से एक मजबूती के साथ पैदा हो रहा है.
Principal Secretary Planning and Development in Jammu and Kashmir Government Rohit Kansal said that Eid prayers were conducted peacefully in Kashmir Valley, including in Baramulla, Ramban, Anantnag, Shopian, Avantipora, Srinagar and other places.
सब जगह जो है ईद प्रेयर्स जो हैं सक्सेसफुली कंक्लूड हो चुके हैं. जैसे जम्मू की मैं बात करूं तो वहां ईदगाह में 5000 से ज़्यादा डिवोटीज ने ईद प्रेयर्स ऑफर की. इसी तरह मैं कश्मीर घाटी की बात करूं तो हमारे पास तमाम जगह से ईद प्रेयर्स जो हैं कंक्लूड होने के, सक्सेसफुली कंक्लूड होने के खबरें आ रही हैं. बारामूला से जहाँ हिस्टोरिक जामा मस्जिद में लोगों ने ईद की प्रेयर्स ऑफर की, इसी तरह रामबन से, इसी तरह अनंतनाग से, शोपियान से, अवंतीपुरा से, श्रीनगर डिस्ट्रिक्ट से, तमाम जगह से हमारे पास खबरें आ रही हैं कि ईद प्रेयर्स जो है सक्सेसफुली कंक्लूड हो चुकी हैं.
And Leh celebrated Eid festival with gaiety. People offered namaz at Eidgah in Leh this morning to offer Eid-e-Namaz. Eid-e-Namaz prayers also included prayers for world peace and harmony, brotherhood and compassion. However, this year a special prayer was offered as a long-cherished dream of the people of Ladakh to become a union territory is finally fulfilled. People exchanged greetings with each other in Leh Main Bazaar. Our correspondent Arun Sharma tells us more about Eid celebrations from Leh. Let's take a look.
Union Unity and diversity, that's the strength of our country, and that's the reason why India is known globally for. And today, in entire India, Eid is being celebrated with great enthusiasm, gaiety and fervor. Well, right now we're in main bazaar of Leh, and behind me you can see this sweet shop. The crowd is thronging here to buy sweets, be it the Muslim brothers and sisters, or maybe the Buddhist brothers or sisters, they are buying sweets here as far as this Eid celebrations are concerned. So after the namaz or after the Eid celebrations, people in large number have come out in the market and they are buying sweets as of now. And this time around, as far as Eid is concerned, it is a double joyous moment for the people of Ladakh, because of the fact that the Ladakhis were looking for a union territory status from last 7 decades, and that dream has finally come true. And of course, this entire week is a long week, or primarily a long festival week for the Ladakhis. We have Eid celebrations, and afterwards we have Raksha Bandhan, and of course on 15th of August we'll be celebrating Independence Day, and Ladakh will be having a double joyous moment for the same fact. And that's the reason people in large number have come out in the markets as far as the Leh main bazaar is concerned. With camera person Mohit Arun Sharma, Doordarshan News, Leh.
And let's listen in to wishes for Eid from Leh.
तमाम लद्दाखी की तरफ से पूरे वर्ल्ड में पीस, अमन, हार्मनी होने का एक संदेश देते हैं. बेसिकली देख ये ईद मनाने का संदेश ये है कि हमारे प्रॉफेट मोहम्मद इब्राहिम अलैहिस्सलाम ने काफ़ी सेक्रीफाइस दिया. गॉड का एक टेस्ट था हाउ टू सेक्रीफाइस. इवन गॉड ने उनको अपना एक टेस्ट लिया था, तो वो उसी टेस्ट में कामयाब हुआ, तभी ये वर्ल्ड एग्जिस्ट हुआ. तो इसी तरह अमन, भाईचारा, मतलब ब्रदरहुड, इसी तरह एक पूरे वर्ल्ड में इसीलिए एक वो संदेश देते हैं.
And the festival of Eid al-Adha is also being celebrated in other parts of the country with religious fervor. The festival was celebrated across India. It commemorates the willingness of a prophet Ibrahim to sacrifice his son as an act of obedience to God. The festival marks the end of the Hajj pilgrimage for Muslims in New Delhi. Thousands attended special Eid namaz at Jama Masjid. People were seen exchanging greetings and warm wishes on the occasion. Similar scenes of worship and exchange of greetings were seen in Mumbai as well. In other states too, the festival was celebrated with great fervor and traditional warmth. And troops of Border Security Force exchanged sweets in Meghalaya with the border guard of Bangladesh. A BSF official said that both India and Bangladesh have deep ties and share similar cultures and languages. He further added that both the nations will continue celebrating festivals in the same way that they have been doing so for years.
Congratulate and convey my best wishes, greetings to my counterpart, Commander Humayu, on the occasion of Holi Eid al-Adha. Secondly, we are the friendly country, and these are the part of confidence building measure which have been started in 2011, and I am sure and I promise you it will continue like this. We will keep celebrating Eid together. We will keep celebrating together.
President Ramnath Kovind, Vice President Venkaiah Naidu and Prime Minister Narendra Modi have greeted people on the occasion of Eid al-Adha. The President in his message said, I quote, on the occasion of Eid ul-Zuha, I offer my greetings and good wishes to all fellow citizens, especially our Muslim brothers and sisters in India and abroad. Eid al-Zuha symbolizes love, fraternity and service to humanity. Let us commit ourselves to these universal values that represent our composite culture. In a tweet, Vice President Venkaiah Naidu said that the festival is an ode to the virtues of devotion, faith and sacrifice and inspires feelings of brotherhood, compassion and unity. The Vice President tweeted, "May the noble ideals of Eid ul-Zuha enrich our lives with peace and harmony and bring prosperity to our country." Prime Minister Narendra Modi also greeted people on the occasion of Eid ul-Adha. In a tweet, the PM said, "My best wishes on the occasion of Eid al-Adha. I hope it furthers the spirit of peace and happiness in our society. Eid Mubarak." Minister of External Affairs S. Jaishankar met Wang Yi, Foreign Minister of China in Beijing. The External Affairs Minister co-chaired the second meeting of the India-China High-Level Mechanism on Cultural and People-to-People Exchanges. Addressing the gathering, External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jaishankar said that four MOUs were signed between the two countries.
We have just now concluded four MOUs agreements. Which include, one, promoting cultural exchanges for the preservation of intangible cultural heritage, organization of cultural activities, and management of archaeological heritage sites. Two, enhance cooperation in the field of traditional medicine, where both countries have a rich knowledge accumulated over centuries, with the objective of promoting the development of traditional medicine in the healthcare systems of the two countries. Three, promote exchanges between our national sports association, sportspersons, and youth for strengthening cooperation on international sports events. And four, cooperation in museum management for promoting collaboration between the Hubei Provincial Museum, Wuhan, and the National Museum, New Delhi, in the field of exhibitions, protection and restoration of collections, and archaeological excavations for museums.
On his maiden visit to China since taking over as External Affairs Minister, S. Jaishankar held discussions on how to further promote cultural exchanges between the two countries and also preparations for upcoming high-level exchanges.
Foreign Minister Wang Yi and I have just now co-chaired the second meeting of the High-Level Mechanism on Cultural and People-to-People Exchanges. The High-Level Mechanism was an outcome of the consensus reached between Prime Minister Modi and President Xi during their informal summit. It reflected our shared agreement that enhancing and strengthening cultural and people-to-people exchanges would contribute to overall development of our bilateral relations. In our discussions today, Mr. Wang Yi and I reviewed the progress made since the last meeting. We also discussed some new proposals and ideas to promote such exchanges. As a result, we have also agreed to organize 100 activities to further strengthen our people-to-people ties.
Addressing the gathering, Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi appreciated India's concerns over trade imbalances while adding that China is ready to continue to provide facilities to Indian exports.
"We're of the view that we need to further deepen our practical economic and trade cooperation. China appreciates India's concerns over trade imbalances, ready to continue to provide facilities to Indian exports to China. At the same time, we need to think more broadly and expand cooperation in investment, industrial production, tourism, border trade, and other areas so that we can achieve overall balance in our economic and trade relations."
And some weather news now. Rescue and relief work is on in full swing in flood-ravaged districts of Karnataka, with a let-up in the rains and water receding in most of the affected areas. And moving on now, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will feature in a special episode of the iconic survival television series Man vs. Wild on Discovery Channel tonight. It will be broadcast at 9 p.m. The show will be hosted by renowned adventurer Bear Grylls. Shot in a Jim Corbett National Park, the show will create awareness about environmental changes and wildlife conservation. The episode will be showcased in over 180 countries across the world on Discovery Network channel.
On an epic adventure of a lifetime.
You are the most important man in India. My job is to keep you alive.
And with that, we wind up this edition of the news. News and updates continue on DD News. Stay tuned. Namaskar.
जल है